know that bat's ready for me.
So what? You were talking about
the company. Yeah, yeah, but we saved the company until after we bring it. So right now, this bat's got to be 30 ounces in the end. Right now, it weighs 30.4, so it's going to be 4 times that over. Now, once we put paint on it, it'll actually gain weight from the paint. So what we'll do is then we'll turn around and we'll go ahead and we'll cut that weight, whatever it gains out. So when we do send it, it'll weigh exactly 30 ounces. Give me within a certain range. Now, if that was no cut, I would have to turn something along the lines of like an 88 ounce and turn it lighter. So instead of turning it to 30 ounces, I would turn it to 29. So that way it would gain that weight back up and then it would weigh exactly 30 ounces. Yeah, there's, believe it or not, there's a lot of that. Every single one of them is different. That order there is going to take about 25 minutes to have an hour. That order was different. Now, if you give me a 50 bat order and every single one of those bats are the same from start to finish, that's only going to take me about an hour and a half or 2 hours. No, so Tim, the owner up there now, he was one of the original bat turners. He would cut them by hand. They were done out of that there. We didn't get this until like 2010 is when the company got hold of this one. I'm grateful.
Yeah, sure. That saves you a day.
Turning it by hand, I'm only going to be able to do 1 or 2 bats a day. Unless we have the only way to turn them by hand and be able to keep up with this machine here, we would need probably about 45 people working. Each with their own machine, Plus, they would have to be highly experienced to be able to make sure that every single one of them are going to have the exact same measurements. Where this machine here, I can turn it back today, 100 years later, turn it back again, there's actually no physical difference.
And the baseballs compressing, and then once they get to the trampoline point, it goes farther. So, and they had a big 2019 winter meeting. They were saying that the U.S. Forestry Department and TECO, who oversees all major leagues and minor league wood bats, did a study, and they actually figured out that a raw maple bat with no finish on it, no compressing, actually sends it further than any bat that's compressed with a curved finish. Not green, so where did all the metal bat companies put that weight? Right here. So then all of a sudden they become even more dangerous because now they're drop threes, but the people that are swinging them feel it because it's all right in the hands and the barrels are coming around even faster. And then they said, well, we got to fix that. Then they went to BESR, ball exit speed ratio. So then they toned down the metal part of it, not the actual weight. So it's not a weight issue. So I have people that are swinging that model, you know, the black one. They can swing this faster as an even bass than they kind of drop through.
Most times it's just too heavy. We're putting this thing got primer on it, now we're stuck. Behind us here we have some throw bats for different guys. I don't even know who most of them are. I don't care.
first time at the Hall of Fame. All right, so the question we always get is, why are we in Cooperstown? Why is the Hall of Fame here? Why aren't we in Providence, Rhode Island, or Long Beach, California, or anywhere else? So here's the short answer to that question, as short as we can get it. In 1905, the powers that be in baseball, the owners, decided they wanted to know where baseball came from. And of course, in 1905, there was no internet. Did not type in Google, where did baseball come from? So they used the 1905 equivalent of the internet, which was newspapers. They sent out thousands of classified advertisements to papers all over the country. A little two-sentence ad that said, if you know how baseball got started, write us a letter and tell us. And the reason they were doing this was, there was a raging debate at the time about whether baseball was purely an American sport, played only in America, or whether it had evolved from other classic stick and ball games like cricket. So about 2 years later, in 1907, a mining engineer living in Colorado named Abner Graves sees one of these little ads in his local paper and writes a letter to the editor to the Akron Beacon Journal, a paper located outside of Cleveland, Ohio, so is this today. And he says, yeah, I know how baseball got started. In 1839, Graves wrote, I was a boy of 5 years old living in Cooperstown, New York, and I watched as Admiral Doubleday was commanding a Union Army regiment who was encamped in Cooperstown doing its maneuvers. And Doubleday laid out the bases in a field for recreation for his soldiers on their downtime. And that, according to Admiral Graves, is how baseball began. And when the owners read this, they absolutely loved it. Because at the time, Doubleday had no known
Everyone in this building belongs here.
Catch up the vlog real quick. Guys, we're still in Cooperstown. We just finished the Hall of Fame, got food, and now we're at the hat store because I'm a hat fanatic, and Davino also wants a hat. And I don't know what I want else to.
About to go Gucci in a Gucci store.
Fresh out the beds in this motherfucker.